Hello students, welcome to my class of electrostatics in dielectric medium. In the last class, we have discussed about nonpolar molecules and we have seen that in this type of molecules, there is no intrinsic dipole moment. However, if we apply external electric field, induced dipole moment can be generated. But some molecules have built-in permanent dipole moments. Such example is water molecule. Now here oxygen is more electronegative atom. So electrons tend to cluster around this oxygen atom. And since the molecule is bent in 105 degree, this leaves a negative charge at the vertex here and a net positive charge at the positive end here. Okay, so here you can see now it looks like a dipole. Here also this is one dipole and here also this is another dipole. So resultant dipole moment we can get along this direction. And this is a matter of fact that the dipole moment of H2O is very very large, of the order of 10 to the power minus 30 coulomb meter. Now in this lecture we will see that what will happen to this type of molecules if these molecules are placed in external electric field. Okay, so if we apply external electric field, this positive charge will feel one force along this direction that we can denote like F plus, and negative charge will feel force along this direction that we can denote as F minus. Now here these two forces are equal, but here they form a couple, so there will be a torque will be generated here. And the torque acting on this dipole, actually here it is making a theta angle with the direction of the electric field. Now the torque will try to rotate this dipole along this electric field. So that means this torque will do some work for rotating this dipole along the electric field. Now what will be the form of this torque? That is P cross E. And it becomes P sine theta. In the next page, we will see that how this form is coming. So for the time being, you consider the torque is P E sine theta. Now what will be the work done? Work done, you know, tau d theta. So the work done will be dW equal to P E sine theta d theta if we want to rotate the dipole by d theta angle. Okay, so total work done will be, if we consider the dipole is rotating from initial position of angle theta 1 to the final position of the angle theta 2, then the work done will be PE cos theta 1 minus cos theta 2. Now let's find out the form of torque which we have used just before, and also the force which is applied on the dipole. Now, if we consider uniform field, in that case, the force on the positive end, positive charge and the negative charge will exactly cancel, okay? But they are forming a couple, that's why this dipole is rotating, that's we discussed in the last page. Now, if we consider this is the middle point of the dipole, then from this middle point, the distance of the positive charge is d by 2. And distance from the negative charge from this middle point is d by 2, but the direction is minus sine because it is the opposite direction. So that's why here we can write d by 2 cross qe, that is the force, positive force F plus, and here minus d cross minus qe, that this force is applied on the negative charge, and we can get qd cross e. So QD we know is the dipole moment and we can get P cross E. But if we put the dipole in non-uniform field, so in that case, this positive 4 plus F plus force does not exactly balance the F minus force. So these two forces will not exactly cancel out. So there will be a net force on the dipole along with the torque, right? So let's find out the force. Now to find out the force, the potential energy of the dipole placed in the external electric field has to be found out. Now what will be the potential energy of the dipole? Now you know that if we consider the potential of this point charge at some particular point at r distance, that we can consider phi r. So for this, suppose from here this is r direction, the r distance from this is the origin, and this will be r plus d. Okay, so from here, if from minus q, if we consider the potential at O point is phi r, so from here positive charge, it will be phi r plus d, right? So this minus q is coming from here. So this will be the total charge. This is the simple algebraic addition of the potential energy of due to these two charges. So potential due to minus q charge is phi r, and potential of plus q charge is phi r plus d. So if we multiply with the charge, right, here minus q and here plus q, it will give us the potential energy at that point. Now if we consider this is a very small dipole, so d is very less than this distance r, then this phi r plus d can be expanded in a Taylor series. Now if we expand the, this is the first term and this is the first linear term, and there will be other higher order terms that will, there will, in the higher order terms there will be del square, del cube, that type of terms. Now as d is also d square, as d is very small here, so the higher order terms we can neglect because that is of high powers. So as d is very small, we can neglect the higher order terms, okay, because that value is very small compared to these two terms. So that's why we are keeping this term up to the first linear term. Okay, now here is minus q phi r. Here also this will be q phi r, so that will cancel out and we will get q d dot del phi r. Now q d, you know, is the dipole moment. So, and electric field is minus grad phi r. So here will be minus sign, so minus p dot here. So this is very important formula of potential energy of any dipole in presence of external electric field. Okay, now as this is a non-uniform field, the force which will be applied on the dipole, that for that we have to operate gradient on the potential energy, and we have to put on minus sign. Okay, so potential energy form already we have obtained, and here we are getting this form. Now here we have to use the vector calculus identity, that del dot p dot e. So the first term will be like this, p dot del e, then e dot del p, then p cross curl e, and fourth term is e cross curl p. Now as p is a constant vector here, because this is a very small length we have considered, so curl p will be 0, as well as this term is also 0. And as we are considering this is electrostatic field, and you know that for electrostatic field curl E equal to 0, so only this term is left here in the form of the force which is applied on the dipole. Okay, so total torque which is applied on the dipole in a non-uniform field, we can write like this. So that is the form which we are getting for uniform field, and this is for non-uniform field. So here F form is this, so R cross this F. Okay, so keeping this in mind, let's discuss the electric polarization. So now this is a dielectric medium, and we are considering this is a polar dielectric medium. So when there is no electric field, the intrinsic dipoles are randomly oriented. Why they are randomly oriented? Because of thermal agitation. Thermal agitation means thermal energy. So due to suppose we have some particular finite temperature, and for that there will be kinetic energy of the individual molecules, and they will be randomly oriented. They will be always vibrating. So if we find out the average dipole moment here, so the average dipole moment will be zero. Okay, but if we apply electric field along this particular direction, then the positive point, positive end will feel force along this electric field, and negative end will feel force in the opposite direction, and they will be oriented along the electric field direction. Now these charges are called bound charge, because they are bound to the nucleus and they are orienting along the electric field. So these are the bound charge. But inside the dielectric medium, that means the insulating material, there is small number of free charges also there. The number is very small in number, of the free charge number is very small compared to the bound charge. So during numerical purpose, we can neglect this free charge value when we are dealing with a numerical problem in dielectric medium. In that case, we can neglect the free charge. Okay, but as the number is very small. Okay, so here we are getting a resultant moment along this direction. So individual dipole has dipole moments, right? So we can tell that individual dipole moment is pi, and suppose there are n number of capital N number of dipoles. So in that case, total dipole moment will be summation of 1 to n pi. Now what is capital P? Capital P is called electric polarization, sometimes called electric polarization vector, because this is a vector term, vector parameter. So the definition of electric polarization is the induced total dipole moment per unit volume. And here the volume, whatever we are considering, that is very much small, infinitesimal small volume. So the polarization is induced dipole moment, total dipole moment per unit volume. Now in the next lecture, we will discuss the concept of this bound charge and what will be the field or potential of this bound charges due at some particular external point of a polarized object. Okay, thank you.